So
$4
on the other day we stopped here in the purchasing configurations. So the issue what has happened on the other day is that the system has mapped with different business group for the OE. So I'll just show you this one.
Sorry, can you repeat again? What is the issue?
Yeah, what has happened is that we did not create a separate responsibility. So we created in the generic responsibility in the general ledger. So what system has taken is that the vision operations instead of our operating unit. I'll show you probably. Yeah, so here if you see, so this one HW_USA I created after our last session. Okay, so on our session basically we created these two things, that is HWOU and OU2. So we did not create a separate responsibility for human resource. So we used human resource that was given by Oracle, the seeded responsibility. So in the profile option or the MOSC profile option, so it has taken Vision Corporation as a business group. So we did not notice that. So it has taken by default a business group as Vision Corporation because we don't have any mapping in the system. It is based on the profile option that is assigned to this particular responsibility. So usually we will create a responsibility and then assign profile option and then we will create the respective organization, but I created directly, so that was the issue. So now I created a responsibility, and after assigning the profile option, I created one more operating unit, that is HWUSA. So this is assigned to our business group. Okay. Yeah. So now it is reflecting correctly. So with that operating unit, I created also the inventory organization. So which we created on the other day for HWOU1. So similar configuration. So I created for this one as well. That is inventory parameters. We gave this one, right? Account code combinations. So that I gave. Yeah, so we will start with PIVO configurations. Yeah, so this is the one that we created. So I'll give options one. Okay, same issue.
Tomorrow morning I won't be available. I mean, I'm traveling tomorrow morning.
Yeah, we will have it evening time, so we will make this one regular. Like, like 8 to this time, we will have this.
Sure.
I think this is happening only for purchasing options. Give me a minute. Okay, so let me start from here. That is from financial options to receivable options. And then probably we'll see this one, purchasing options. Okay, I think the account is not defined. Basically, financial option is a crucial setup wherein this will be our source of account code combination when we basically generate our invoices, generate or we create any manual invoices. So there are basically two ways of creating an invoice. I mean, we can say it is three way. So one is that manual way of creating manual invoice, and the another one is that getting the PO or receipt from a procurement application, and we will match it with our invoice, or probably we will receive this invoice from the external application, that is from the core application or the third party application. So these are the three different ways of getting the invoices. So now, let's say I'm creating an manual invoice. So what I can do is that I can create a manual invoice, and in distribution, I can give the expense account, but I will not be able to give the liability account. So from where basically system will pick the liability account is that as a first step, system will check in vendor site level. So if this liability account or the prepayment account is not given in the vendor site, so it will look for the financial options. So that is why it becomes a mandatory setup here. So if the particular configuration is not given in the vendor site, so that is when system will come and pick from here. So this is the source to create our liability account generation. Okay. So this is based on the operating unit. So let's say I have 10 different vendors. So for all 10 different vendors, so this will be my liability account. So this will be my combination. So similarly, prepayment and discount taken as well. Okay. And then we have a future period. So future period is nothing but that the certain transactions that I can enter, but I'll not be able to do accounting or complete the accounting process. That is, I can keep it in the final stage, but I'll not be able to post this to the general ledger. So this we call as a future period. Okay. So the reason why we will have this option of having future period is that it's not that always we will have leisure time to create the transaction now and there and complete it. So there will be certain activities when we speak about the year-end processing. So we have adjustment entries, and then we have reconciliation entries. Other things will come in. So these entries might be small, or these entries might be big. Based on the organization count or the volume of the transaction that they are making. Okay. So let's say I wanted to make 100 or 200 transactions, which is not at all possible if I do it in one day. So this will consume my one complete day. So instead, what I will do is that I'll give one feature period. So this one feature period will give me access wherein I can create the transaction, and I will save it, and I will validate it, and I will keep it ready for posting. So next day when the period opens, what I will do is that I'll just run this particular accounting program. So this accounting program will run as a batch. So this batch will push the entire transaction to our GL module. Okay, so for that purpose, we have this future period. So this option is there in GL as well. So we have it in AP side also. Okay. So basically the financial option, if you see this more of an, what do you call, the accounts payable, but this we will see it also in the purchasing side of it. Okay. So that's what, and then there are other few accounts as well, like bills payable. So bills payables are used when we have letter of credit or kind of an instrument wherein we will get a guarantee and we will get paid. But this is considered as a short-term debt. So for those cases, we will use bills payable functionality. Okay. And then other things are like the PO rate variance gain or loss. So these are the things. Okay. And then we have the expense clearing account. So if I want to use the clearing account, I can utilize this. But these are the three mandatory accounts that we might need. Okay. And then miscellaneous. So miscellaneous is nothing but the line that we can add. So we have freight, we have tax, we have normal lines. So apart from that, we have any requirement to capture the financial charges or the bank charges. So those things can be captured using this particular line item called miscellaneous. So if we want to set up any specific account code combination, we can set it up here. Or probably we can use it at transaction. That is when we are creating the invoice. Okay. So then we have the retainage earnings account. So this is kind of an holding a particular amount and releasing at a later point. So at high level, so these are the three accounts that is mandatory. So we have given it. And then we have supplier purchasing. Okay. So here also we have only one column that is mandatory, that is inventory organization. So apart from that, we also can capture ship to location and bill to location for a particular operating unit. So I'll select the inventory organization. Okay. And then we have encumbrance. So encumbrance is nothing but kind of a budget wherein it is an unplanned budget, we can say. So we will see this when we are seeing budgets. Okay, and these are like compliance related information. And here we can see our business group and these things. Okay, so that's about the financial option. Any doubt or we can move on?
Yeah, please, Lord.
Okay, so the next thing is that receiving options. Okay. So we created a separate inventory unit for this newly created operating unit. So that is HWINV unit. So this is the new unit that we created. Okay, so basically we will give configuration for this particular unit. Okay, so to start with, so we have enforce. So this is a kind of a control wherein we can say whether system wants to give the warning or it wants to reject particular transaction. So that is the understanding. And here you can see that enforce ship to location. So whether if there is no ship to location, whether I want to reject it or I just want to give the warning and I will get the data inside my system. Okay, so I can give this option. So this is not mandatory. So I'm just leaving this as none. And then we have ASN control action. So ASN is nothing but advance shipment notice. So where we will use this process is that, let's say we have a requirement. So wherein we have different countries that is being involved. So let's say I'm a manufacturer who manufactures car, let's say BMW or some other company. So I manufacture cars and I sell it to Australia. I sell it to probably Asian countries like probably Japan or the other countries. Okay. So in this case, since it will have different checkpoints. So it will not come directly from, let's say, India to Australia. So we have multiple checkpoints. Let's say it moves from India to probably Chennai to Mumbai, and from Mumbai to, let's say, Singapore, and from Singapore it will reach to Australia, and from there again we will unpack and then we will give a new build and all those things. Okay, so in this entire process, what will happen is that each checkpoint will be captured. So each shipment should be captured. So this functionality of ASN, why we will use this particular functionality is that to capture the each checkpoint's action items. So if I have reached a specific point, so I will give a notification, advance notification, that so-and-so shipment is coming to this particular inventory at the bureaus. Because it is not that always I will have the oracle space in my inventory at the bureaus. So when I have the advance notice in, let's say 10 days before the delivery. So I will plan accordingly. But when it comes on a particular day, so I might not plan it. So that is the reason we are having this advance shipment notice, so that we can plan our inventory or warehouse items. Okay. So that's about it. So whether we wanted to use it or not, so we can give, whether we want to give warning or these things. Okay. And then we have a receipt days early. So early, let's say I'm giving just, this is kind of in control. So just for this thing, I'm giving one day. That is, 1 day can be early and 1 day can be late. Okay. And then if the receipt days exceeds action, so it includes this 1 day also. So after this, what system should do? So whether system should reject or it should give a warning and it should accept it. So for now, I'll give a warning. I'm not giving reject option. Okay. And then we have over receipt tolerance. So over receipt tolerance is something that, let's say I ordered for 10 quantity, but now I'm receiving 11 quantity, or by mistake I'm receiving it. So whether I can allow this 1%, or this could be above or below. So whether I can allow this particular tolerance or not. So that is what we are defining. So if we don't want to have tolerance, probably we can say 0%. Or let's say I want to have tolerance, I can give probably 10%. Okay. And then over receipt action. So whether we wanted to take any action, that is to reject this particular receipt, or what do we want to do exactly? So I'll say none here. Okay. And then we have RMA. So that is the returns and this thing. So receipt routing. So how do we want to handle this? So we have different options. So whether we wanted to have a direct delivery. So direct delivery is nothing but I just receive into my inventory directly. So there is no delivery or this thing involved. Directly I will get into my inventory as the sub-inventory. The other option that we have is standard receipt. So standard receipt will have the delivery challan also. So this is kind of a two-way. Okay. And then we have inspection record. So inspection is something that we will have the quality control and the other checks also. So after the entire process is done, so we will mark this as an delivered. So that is when the actual delivery will happen. So this is what we also call it as a two-way, three-way, or four-way. So not exactly same, but we can match it with this. Okay. So whether we want to match with PO, receipt, or the inspection. So that is what we call as an two-way, three-way, and four-way matching. So similarly here, if you see, we have inspection, and then we have direct delivery, and we have the standard receipt. Okay. So for now, I'll just say standard receipt. Okay. And also for the receipt routing, I'll give standard receipt. So whether I want to give whether I want to allow substitute a receipt, I can enable this. For now, I'm just leaving it. Okay, and then I have allow unordered receipt. So allow unordered receipt is nothing but, let's say let's say there is an requirement wherein I wanted to book this receipt above the quantity ordered. So which means I ordered for 5 and I'm receiving it, it's probably the overt quantity of it. So whether I wanted to allow unordered receipt. So usually it is not suggestible. So I'm just leaving this as an open. And then we have allow express transaction. So these are like optional configurations. So I'm just leaving this also not enabling. And then we have a cascade transaction, and then bind receiving. So these are like exceptional cases wherein we will try to enter the receipt and get the item on the exceptional cases. Okay. And then we have validate serial number on RMA receipts. So if it is returned, so whether we wanted to validate this particular thing with our serial numbers so that we can enable it here. Okay, and then we have reset number generation, whether we wanted to have it as a manual or we wanted to have this as an automatic. Okay, and then we have a reset number type, so whether we want to have only the numeric or the alphanumeric. So we can say the reset number, so I say one as an first number. Okay, so then we have lots on RMA resets, so whether we wanted to give any sort of restrictions on the lots. So lots and locators are different. So lot is nothing but a set of an batch or the set of batch of an item. So when we speak about the manufacturing, so it's not about what do you call the quantity of an item, it is about the batch. So batch production will be different, and after packaging it becomes a combo of an item or however the business runs. Okay, so this lot and the locator will come. Okay, we will talk about it when we see the inventory part. So that is item creation and these things, we will talk about it. So for now I'll just say this is an unrestricted. Okay, so then we have the receiving inventory account. So when we book and delivery, so there will be an accounting impact. So this is where basically it will pick from. So I'll just give the account.
Arun, sorry, I am getting an office call actually.
Okay.
Can we connect tomorrow?
Yeah, sure, no problem. Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah, no problem.